Everyone, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. So if this is your first time watching, my name is Sheridan. This is a little ghosty. She does not like being picked up right now. Ghosty, say hi. She is one of my cats. For today's video, we are going to be talking all about Brazilian waxes. Oh my god, there's cat hair flying everywhere now. Help. If you'd like to learn my thoughts on Brazilian waxes and hear some of the answers to your questions that you asked me on Instagram, plus a little bit of information from my waxing specialist, then stay tuned. Yeah, I was feeling inclined to make this video because when I started doing research and wanting to look into getting Brazilians done, there was really nothing out there on YouTube, and really there wasn't anything out there. I've been going now, like, since the summer, six or so times, perhaps six or seven. So I did look now, and there are a couple good videos out there that seem super informational, so I thought I would just put this out there, give you guys my take on it. I'll just long story short it on my experience, then we'll get into the juicy stuff of what you guys probably actually want to hear is your questions and then the stuff from my waxing specialist. My experience is I was struggling with ingrown hairs, like on the bikini line to no end. It was so painful. Like, I would wear leggings commando and I would be in so much pain still just from these ingrown hairs I was getting from shaving. I decided in the summer I would try a Brazilian wax. I had a bikini wax before, so I kind of knew what I was getting into. Started, I loved it, and I've never looked back since, to be honest. It's, to me, the most convenient, the least stressful, and it's the least time consuming. I don't struggle with ingrown hairs anymore, like hardly at all. I'll maybe get like one or two, if that, within the month, like in between. So yeah, I go once a month. Typically I'll schedule about, like, you know, 30 days apart, 4 weeks apart. I go to European Wax Center in Eastwood Town Center, if any of you guys are in the East Lansing area and are interested in checking that out. My waxing specialist, her name is Lydia. She is so awesome, and I will have her info linked below. If you're interested, you can definitely check her out. She is great. So this is just a little bit of information that Lydia gave to me, that I told her, hey, I'm gonna be filming a video. And I asked, you know, if there was any advice you could give to, you know, my subscribers, what would you tell them? So I'm just gonna read exactly what she wrote to me. So she said, hard wax is better for your skin because it doesn't adhere to the skin as much as soft wax does, so it doesn't take off as many skin layers, which, by the way, we use hard wax. So this means it's great for people who have sensitive skin, acne, or acne-prone skin, and just better for everyone in general. Also, since hard wax doesn't take off as much skin as soft wax, it tends to be a lot less painful. And this is verbatim, again, what she's saying for you guys. She also said, exfoliating helps for waxing because it helps pop out shorter hairs from the skin so the wax can wrap around the hair more easily. And it helps prevent ingrown hairs and gets rid of dead skin cells. Coming every 4 to 5 weeks for Brazilians is ideal. Being consistent with waxing will get you the best results. And this is true. She also said, the hair comes back in softer, more thin, and some will start to not grow back at all. So it gets easier. So yeah, she really like summed it up. Staying consistent with it actually makes it get better and better and better and better. The very first time I went compared to now is like nothing. Like, it's not that painful, it's super easy. The other reason I really like Lydia is that she does it really quick. Like, you're in and out of there probably, like, I'm in and out of there like less, 20 minutes or less, usually like 15 minutes like at the most, and that's because we're talking. She does like a like larger amounts at once, and then when she rips it off, it like all goes faster. So to get into your questions, so the first question says, pain level, downtime, things you wish you knew prior. So pain level, again guys, with my lip injections and my tattoos, I'm kind of a bad person to ask about pain. I have built up a pretty high pain tolerance. Again, I think it matters for things that you want. So if you truly want this done, it's gonna be more worth it to you. The first time it is gonna hurt, it's not gonna feel good, but also it's a very like, it's a quick pain. It's almost like if someone were to like slap you super hard, it hurts for like maybe 2 seconds, literally, no joke. Lydia will like push down and like put pressure on the spot, and then it's like the pain is gone instantly. You don't really feel sore afterwards. There really isn't a lot of downtime. In my research, it did tell me if you go tanning 24 hours before. And additionally, you're supposed to wait 24 hours to throw it back and do the nasty, if you know what I mean. So if that's something, you know, if you are planning on being intimate with your lover, I would perhaps abstain from 24 hours, at least for your first time. Other than that, the only other thing I wish I knew prior to starting was that, like, you pretty much are gonna love the result and not want to stop. So it's definitely, you know, it's like, it's a $50 a month expense that I've committed to, because I am keeping it up, because if you stop going, that first time pain is gonna be even more. So it's gonna hurt worse if you stop going and just like randomly go. But if you keep it up once a month, my hair truly has grown back like thinner, softer, like not as coarse, and it's a lot easier to remove. Next question. How many swear words did you say? How many weird positions did you have to get in? My first time, I think I may have sworn a little bit, but I tend to just like grab the table that I'm laying down on, and then I just like breathe and it's fine. And then how many weird positions you have to get in? So basically, like, what you do is like you lay down on your back on this table and kind of put your legs like in a triangle and like spread apart. It's like a butterfly stretch. You put your feet together like a butterfly stretch and you like lay back. So like your legs are apart, everything is like easy for her to see and get to. And then for like the butt part, you basically just like pull your knees up to your chest so that it like lifts your legs up and your butt. Honestly, the butt part, like, that part does not hurt at all to me. Like, that part hurts the least out of everything, probably because it's like the most like fat and it's not on bone, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, so those are really only the two positions. I know other people do it in different positions. Like, I did see one other person before I started going to Lydia, and I can't remember how she had me lay. I think she had me lay the same, like butterfly, legs apart like that. Feet together, knees apart, butterfly, but then she had me like flip over on my stomach to do the butt part. So I think it's kind of different, you know, waxing specialists do it differently. So it really just depends. And it depends on what you're comfortable with. You know, of course, like if you want to be in a certain position, I'm sure you guys can work it out. Another question asks, is there any major irritation? Again, really the initial, you know, pain is like right when she's removing the wax, and then afterwards, I mean, I personally didn't feel any irritation. Maybe like a little bit of redness for some people. Like if you've ever waxed your lip or your brow, you know, there's gonna be a little bit of redness initially. Another question says, does it effing hurt? It really just depends on your pain tolerance, and all I have to say is it is a quick pain. It's like a slap. Like, if someone slaps you as hard as you can imagine, it's gonna hurt and sting at first for the first couple seconds, and then it goes away. So it's not like a lasting pain, it's very quick. Another question says, how long does it take for the hair to grow back? This is an awesome question. So this really depends person to person. Another thing I wanted to mention is that we actually have two sets of, like, hair growth cycles. I hope I'm explaining this right. Lydia, if you're watching. We have two hair growth cycles. So one is growing and one is kind of under the skin ready to grow up after. If you've ever noticed, like if you shave and like the day after, like immediately like a new hair is there, that's kind of what that's from. Your first time, you might notice, like I said, like everyone's hair growth is different. I'm a very hairy person. So for me, this is just my experience. So my first time was great, like the first day. I want to say probably like the second or third day, I did notice 4 or 5, like just like super small, like little hair sprouts, like barely noticeable, just like at the surface. For me, it was 2 weeks. I started to notice more like actual hair growth, like everywhere. Hair itself is a lot thinner. It's less coarse, and it's a lot, and the growth is a lot thinner, so there's just less hair. So, I mean, like, you're gonna be completely bald for, like, probably within the first 1 to 2 weeks, depending on your hair growth and what that's like, and, you know, you can yourself, like, tweeze those couple first initial sprouted hairs that were kind might have been like from the second hair growth cycle. But the good thing is like once those two cycles match up, you really only have one growth cycle, and then you'll probably not have hair until like the second, third, and then into your fourth week. That being said, your hair does have to be at least of a fourth of an inch long for the first time. You can kind of talk to your waxing specialist and decide like what's good for you guys, like if it's long enough, if it's not. Wax just has to have something to grab onto, so keep that in mind. Thinking about trying it soon, how is the first time? Again, the first time is honestly the worst. Mostly because A, you don't know what to expect, so you're scared, like you already have like adrenaline going and it's gonna be a little bit more painful. For your first time, I would also recommend... Hi, Kalani. Are you joining us? I would recommend staying away from caffeine or alcohol the first 24 hours leading up to your first appointment, because caffeine actually like tightens your pores and can constrict like the skin around the hair to make it hurt more, because like it's going to be tighter around the actual hair follicle. And then obviously alcohol, you know, is going to kind of just skew your experience. So I would definitely stay away from those two things for your first time. But after the first time too, it's also the best because you're literally shook at how like one thing can be so smooth in your life. Wraps it up for the questions. Just as closing information of the rest of the things I can think of, I do kind of struggle with exfoliating, so no matter what, like my skin just has a hard time exfoliating, which is why I did struggle so much with ingrown hairs. So it's important to still continue exfoliating, like while waxing does help the exfoliating process, you need to continue doing it like in the shower, like weekly kind of situation. I have like a body scrub that I like to use. And I just get it at Meijer. If I can find it, I'll link it for you guys. And it seems to really help me. And I know European Wax Center does offer like an ingrown hair like serum that you can use. It's like an exfoliating serum specifically made to help ingrown hairs. So, you know, keep that on your horizon if that's something you struggle with. Those are kind of some products I like to keep in mind in case I do start to struggle, which I really haven't, but you know, just in case. See, this helped you if you are looking into getting into doing Brazilian waxing. Personally, it's just a really nice way I like to treat myself, and it saves me the hassle of shaving down there and just the really painful ingrown hairs. It's been so nice to just be so comfortable. If you have any more questions regarding this subject, please let me know in the comments below, or if it's super personal, you can always DM me on Instagram. Again, I will have Lydia's information at the European Wax Center. If you are in the East Lansing, Lansing area, you're interested in, you know, starting this, she is amazing. I highly recommend her. And I wanted to thank her again. Thank you, Lydia, for giving us all of this great information that I was able to share with you guys. Please make sure you take the time to subscribe to my channel before you leave and hit that notification bell so that you never miss any of my brand new videos. As always, thanks so much for watching, guys. I will see you in my next video. Bye!